This morning in Legal Logic, we are talking backyard bonfires. And from barbecues to fire pits to neighbors burning brush, yes, here to break down what's legal and what's not is attorney Brian Cuna. Good morning.
Good morning, Brendan.
Don't take away of our summer favorites here, because these are some of the things that we all love to do in summertime. You want to sit outside in the evening. It's beautiful. Relax. Enjoy that air. So let's start with barbecues. What are, you know, what can we do? What can't we do? Because we want to have respect for our neighbors as well.
Okay. We can barbecue anywhere we want as long as it's in our yard.
That's all I needed to hear. That's it. Have a good day, everybody.
Absolutely. Yes. Barbecuing on your private property is generally allowed both in Massachusetts and Rhode Island. You can do it in your backyard. You can have your fire pit in your backyard, but that's about it, okay? If you want to go to the beach, forget about it.
Yeah, you can't be doing that.
You can't. It's generally, the state law in this municipal ordinances in almost every city and town, both in Massachusetts and Rhode Island. Okay. And in the beach towns, it's pretty much not allowed anywhere. In fact, the general rule is no fires on the beach, no barbecuing on the beach. If there are some exceptions, for example, if you go to Truro, or you go way down the Cape someplace, if you go to the Parks and Recreation Department, they do allow you to barbecue on the beach for certain hours, 6 o'clock to 11 o'clock at night, but you need a permit.
Right.
There's very strict regulations about how far you have to be from the grass and so forth and so on. So general rule, no barbecuing on the beach. Some beaches have recreation areas, like Horse Neck. Second Beach has a little recreation area off the beach.
Okay.
Where they have fire pits and they have barbecues and you're allowed to do it there. But that's about it.
Yeah, I don't want a whiff of ribs if I'm on the sand at noontime. You know
what
I mean?
Or you don't want to be walking over hot coals.
Exactly. Yes, very important stuff. Well, let's talk fire pits. They're very popular. What do we need to know here?
Right. Fire pits, again, not allowed on the beach. You are allowed to do it on your private property again, but not on the beach. In certain recreational areas, you are allowed. Bonfires. Okay, there's something. They allow it in Massachusetts and Rhode Island once a year.
Right.
Generally July 4th, July 2nd through July 6th. You want to have a bonfire, you can again go to your fire department, get a permit, and you can do it once a year.
And
but that's about it.
Those of us in it who live in, you know, nice neighborhoods, at some point or another we smell the, you know, the burning brush. What neighbors doing this? Are they allowed to do this?
Okay.
Please tell me I can let them know that they can't do this, because I want a confrontation with my neighbors.
It's really weird between Massachusetts and Rhode Island. In Massachusetts, there's 22 towns that don't allow any burning outside, two of which are Fall River and New Bedford. You cannot burn anything outside. You can't burn your grass, you can't burn hay, you can't burn tires, you can't burn anything outside. However, many towns do allow it, but it's limited to a certain time period, generally between January and May. They don't allow it in the summer for obvious reasons. I mean, we're going through a drought right now, there's no burning outside. But if you do want to do it, you have to go to the fire department, you need to get a permit, you need to have a hose there, you need to have an adult, you have to be over 18. Very, very strict regulations. Now, in Massachusetts, interestingly, you can't burn grass, you can't burn leaves, you can't burn hay. The opposite in Rhode Island. You can do those things, but again, you need to get a permit, you need to go to your fire department, and it's strictly regulated with regard to the time of year you can do
it. Well, it's all such important info, Brian.
Okay.
Thank you very much. As long as I can still make s'mores, that's all I'm looking to do.
Okay.
If you'd like even more legal advice from Brian Cuna and Associates, just head to roadshow.com and click on the Legal Logic channel.